YouTube. What's up, Earthlings? Right. I'm going to be doing my Thanos again today. I'm going to show you very quickly. I've been buying lots of tools, lots of rubbery type ones. Red ones are harder. Wooden type things. I probably won't use most of them, to be honest, but they're there for when I need them. These are probably my favourite little white ones. These are from when I first bought them. They were quite expensive from my dentistry, but I've got all of the different size balls you can ever imagine. And these other carvers and a dry brush and other smoothing things. To mould with a bag of clay, more tools there. Yeah, have a sip of coffee while I think about it. Very nice. Right, and this is the Thanos I'm going to try and recreate. His contented look from at the end of the Infinity War. As you can see, his head is a bit of a more of a different shape now. Sort of more like how he should be. I've still got to do these lines on the side here. They're scars. I'm beginning to think they're kind of just the way his head was formed, because he is a bit of a weirdly shaped being. Make sure it's all nicely zoomed in for you. I'll try not to get my head and hands in the way so much this time. I think my last one I kind of got my head quite early in the way. Oh, I've got a cat on the lap now. Not really best time, Mosey, but I'm sure she'll get off if she realises that she's a bit in the way. Are you coming to help me, Mosey? I do need help, really. Had a bit of a big mishap with this one, actually. Pretty much all of the bottom half of his head, or the back there, decided to fall down. That's why it's supported by this stuff underneath. Sorry, Rosie. What do you think so far, Rosie, eh? Yeah, do you like it? I've been using the technique with the plastic bags. It sort of smooths off the edges as you sort of use it. Very good for doing brow ridges and things. But I found that when it's a little bit too moist, like I have around here, it just stuck in there. I'll try and get this one a lot deeper, really, because see what I mean? It's just a little bit too. So I'm probably going to do that in when it's dry. When it's drier. So I find it a lot easier to get the grooves on them. Yeah, so his, yeah, I mean, if there are scars, it would be pretty good, really, just to sort of yeah, he's got a sort of backstory where he's all been sort of scarred up, and he's got such a small amount of eye showing. I even think that's too much. His right eye, I've got to do a bit more work on, but I'm just trying to do this side of the face because you can't really see much more than what you have here. What I've got, and this is what, starts picking your nose again. I think these are quite good because you can sort of twist them and make them sort of a lot wider or you know, as wide as it is, or you know, look, quite a lot of control. About the depth of the detail and the width of the detail you're putting in. Yeah, I think I'm becoming a little bit too much of a perfectionist with it, maybe, I don't know. It's got to be perfect, and then you sort of go from, I'm sort of going through these pictures, and what you have with his scars and his temple depth and that, and it's sort of different on all of them, and then his ears completely different on, you know, when you, whatever picture you look at. Some of them he's got quite a big sort of arc over this area, and some of his ears he's got sort of more of a, I don't know, a sort of a Vulcan type ear, but this one I've got up at the moment, it's just a very, very small amount of skin he's got lapping over here. It depends, I suppose, on the computer artist at the time. I've noticed I would have to add a little bit more to this bit here, I think. Also, I'm on this sort of very wobbly sort of houseplant stand. Is this anything that kind of rotates well enough? Add this on and then I'm going to have to some of it. Like so. I mean, I'm pretty much just sort of learning from scratch, really, from, you know, because what I've done at school 36 years ago is, you know, is pales into significance of the detail I'm trying to get into Thanos' head. And I'm just, I haven't really used these tools before either. So I'm just sort of learning as I'm going along, really. Yeah, that's Rosie. You might hear a lot from her because she loves a lot of attention. She makes some very strange noises. Yeah, I think I'm just going to leave his ear pretty much as that shape. He's got some very sort of speaking up a gristle, really, his ear, isn't it? Or people's ears. See, this is completely different to an ear I was doing before, so I think I'm just going to have to compromise and just make a sort of one that looks kind of like all of them, or just looks like an ear. Favourite tools I have found is just a wet paintbrush, to be honest. A wet, not too wet. Once you've got the basic shape, you can almost use it to sort of mould clay. It's the shape you want it. definition to detailed sort of brushing. So this one, I mean, it's also these his lines and his face on the corner from now on, not scars necessarily, but they all they seem to be different on each Thanos as well. There is definite, very defined areas like that eye on his brow ridge, obviously. His face, they call sort of cut through the his brow ridges. I'm trying to do this sort of side of his face first, like I said, because you can see it. You know, it's match. It's right hand side to what I've done on the left, basically. Get it over in a bit more, sort of a bit more of a sit an area that I can carve back now, do the sculpting a bit better. I'm just rambling now, waffling on. I did have the news on earlier on, but I was just so fed up looking at what's happening with Brexit that I'm not going to be leaving on the 31st now, because the EU will hopefully grant an extension. Enough time for people. Well, I mean, I'd prefer to have either a really good deal, like a good deal, better than the one Boris has got at the moment, or another vote. I don't think it's going to happen by either. I'd like it if they had just a coalition of parties get together. And I don't really like Boris Johnson, and I really don't like Jacob Rees-Mogg, because just because of the fact that there was a programme on ITV a few months ago now about the Brexit millionaires, and he's been making so many, next Brexit billionaires, I think it was. He's been making so much money out of us leaving the EU. And I think that's sort of, one of the main reasons why he wants to leave the EU, because he's going to make loads of money out of it, him and other people. But anyway, I'm not going to talk about Brexit, I don't really, my vote will remain, but I think that the UK will be good if we do leave. Sure, there's going to be much of a United Kingdom afterwards, though. I think Scotland will vote to leave the United Kingdom. And as for Northern Ireland, well, I don't really know what's going on over there. They don't even seem to be able to get a parliament together at the moment, which is very sad. And then shortly after Wales. Leaves, I think. Scotland leaves. I think Wales would go the same way as well. There's far too much water on there. What am I doing? Yeah, I'm going to see myself just sculpting and sculpting and sculpting this. Never actually get a final version. I realise now that the other one needs a lot more adjusting to make it correct. Even though I've painted it, I can still add new clay to it. doesn't shrink very much at all, really. It's enough to sort of have a, you know, section against some sort of half millimetre size cracks underneath it. Like I said, once it goes dry, I can do a lot of sculpting. When it has dried out, and I've had a lot more fat and gristle to the back of his neck, as you may be able to see. Which I'm going to have to do on the other one. And I'd say his head is sort of not a dome at all. He's got these sort of Klingon ridges, as I like to call them. Sort of muscle head, and he's just all muscle, really, isn't he? He's just a big lump of muscle with a brain. And yeah, you kind of got to the end of Infinity War thinking, yeah, was Thanos right? I mean, there's lots of people saying, was Thanos right? But then you feel the real Thanos. Stop recording. I've just got a message through. No, it's still recording. No, you see the real Thanos come through when in Endgame, he's willing to just kill everyone off and start again. And his perfect vision of the universe. Randomly killing off half of the living creatures in the universe. At the beginning of Endgame, you see the immediate results of it. You've got whales in the Hudson Bay for the first time ever. A lot less boats about. I'm not saying that I'd like it to happen, but it's not going to happen, obviously, because there isn't any Thanoses around. I've seen lots of videos on YouTube about him and Killmonger as well. I think I'm going to have to watch Black Panther again to see what that was all about, because I can't even remember. Yeah, to keep it damp also, I've got this spray bottle that I use to sort of spray water on it. Seems to work really well with the smoothing. Once it's got a bit more dried, a lot harder, get my words out, I will be using the sponge on his head to sort of sponge him down. This big sort of indentation in the back of his head here as well. See on some shots. There's a really good video actually I found of it's Luster Studios or Luster Workshop or something. In a 1-to-1 scale Thanos head. And I think that, you can over detail it, I think. And I'm not saying that one's over detailed. Dry clay on my fingers. I find that a lot with my tools as well, trying to keep them clean after you've used them. I mean, these ridges run around the back of his head as well. I mean, he's got them all over his arms as well, so I don't think they are scars. I think they're just his deformities as a, when he was born on Titan. Maybe that's what made him go a little bit mad. Maybe lots of bullying when he was young, which sort of rings home with me, because I was kind of bullied at school a little bit from being such a small, young person. I've always been small and slim anyway. So yeah, I mean, these are his lines in his head and his body. I think I'll be doing a lot of it in spray bottle down, which I've got a sponge I've got recently as well, which I think would be nice to, yeah, that's quite nice to smooth off large areas, sort of put a bit of definition as well, like this nylon reinforced clay. You do get lumps of nylon around and turning up and spoiling what you're doing. Carefully remove them into the bin. So really all of this needs a little bit more definition as well, really, just helping out his neck muscles that come down, and he's got a jugular vein in lots of shots that you see coming over here, but when he's just standing admiring the garden when he's in his retirement home, his old war machine said, oh, he's got a retirement plan. Jugular vein would not be popping out quite so much. But yeah, that's going quite well. I mean, it's sort of smoothing off a lot of it, making it look a lot more sort of finished and giving me sort of areas that I need to sort of concentrate on more. To get a anatomical sort of muscle skeleton thing that you can look at to sort of see where people's muscles are, because basically he is based on a human being, isn't he? And just with the surface detail being different to a human and the amount of muscle being different to a human. But he is based on a human being, a humanoid figure, humanoid form. So his muscle structures would be very, very similar to how a human's is. Mm-hmm. Grooves. Yeah, it's dripping wet, this with the sponges. I shouldn't have this one. Persevere. Hello, Rosie. Yeah, I know you want some attention again. You're very much an attention wanting cat. Possessive of their human tabby cats are. Tabby? Tortoiseshell. Yeah, tortoiseshell. Yeah, she's tortoiseshell. This eye needs a lot more work, really. It's got a sort of. Bits because I'm kind of worried that I might just muck it up and show myself up on the camera. It's quite difficult to do his eyes. And this quite different to his left eye. I think I've got his left eye kind of how it should be. You think I'm talking to you, don't you, Rosie? Okay. really a tool as such, but I think it's pretty inclusive that you can quite a lot with a sponge and a wet paintbrush, I should say. Yeah, well, I think I'll leave the video there for the time being. I've got to finish this today, really, because I want it to start going hard so I can start putting the skin texture in. So I'm going to be using the method that I did yesterday. I haven't done this method before, actually, so that's why. But I'm going to use a lot of some of these tools I've got. As you can see, I've been using it already on the top of his head, then I re-sculpted his head. So. But he has got hair. I've seen that in some shots you can see he's got a sort of bum fluff moustache, and I don't think that's the one I need to use. I need to have a little bit less pointy, maybe, to give him his hair follicle. No, that's not going to work. It needs to be a pointy one again. In fact, I'm going to go full pointy. And I can't find an area on his head that's not so damp, because that's not really working so well when it's really damp. But yeah, I think I'm going to go back to using this one. It's a really pointy one. But I can't do it until he's dried out a little bit more. I want to sort of get the eyes and the ears done first, and then I can continue with that. How long are we up to in time? Yeah, I'll do another 30-minute video and that'll be it, I think. But yeah, I think I was told by my mate that he quite likes just watching people turning wood and doing sculpting and things. So. They have a bit of clay to his ear, like it is on the other side. So, to this area. So I'll add it and then mould and take away. I don't think these lines are quite white on this side of his head yet, but it's definitely got a much bigger gristly bit up here. His ears. I don't know how human's ears are from left to the right, you know, comparing how equal and how symmetrical they are. I'll try and get his as close to Yeah. I think that you can just leave me to it now, and hopefully I'll have a sculpted Thanos head by the time I see you next. Hope you've liked my little how-to video. It's how I'm doing it. Whether it's how to the way to do it, I'm not sure, but I'm just going to persevere and hope that it comes out a bit better. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you can leave some comments, some suggestions maybe and give me a thumbs up as well. That'd be very much appreciated. Thank you very much. Goodbye, have a good day.